So why is this race, why is this position so important?
Well, there's a lot of ways to answer that question, but if you look at the recent history of the Wisconsin Supreme Court, it has moved strongly to the right. More importantly, perhaps, it's moved strongly to becoming allied with and identified with the political branches. This really shows up in particular in the John Doe investigations. Those are very complicated, but the very short version is Scott Walker and his associates were being investigated for campaign violations in ways that the justices of the court themselves could very easily have been accused of. And the very same parties were involved, the same outside groups, the same kinds of payments to elections. And the justices of the court associated with Governor Walker shut down that investigation. That gave a very strong public appearance of what is called legal corruption. There have been studies, and the Wisconsin court has gone from having one of the cleanest reputations in the country to having one of the most dubious on these grounds. That is, that we're not talking about justices taking bribes in parking garages, but there is a pervasive view that in the last 10 years or less than that, the Wisconsin Supreme Court has become a tool of the political branches and specifically of the Walker administration and the Republican Party. To the extent that that view is shared by voters, it's possible this election is a referendum not so much on Scott Walker as on the court itself. On the other hand, that may be the kind of concern that only a very small number of people pay attention to. A lot of voters in judicial elections in the past have sort of lined up the candidate on, is this person my party or the other party, or supported by my party or the other party, and then check the box that way.
So in my final minute with you, why do you think people should get to the polls next week for the primary?
Well, I feel quite strongly, I'm now speaking personally, not professionally, that the decline in the reputation of the Wisconsin court is a disaster for the state, and really that Wisconsin's reputation for good and clean government was one of our proudest assets. And you can remember years ago how Wisconsinites used to make fun of Illinois, for example. And it dismays me to see Wisconsin come to be viewed as just another one of those states. And so I would hope that people would think hard about which candidate they want to support in terms of what this election will say about the court, as well as about the governor or the state at large.
Thank you so much for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
Howard Schwaber, a professor of political science and legal studies at UW-Madison.